An impressive chest isn't just about size. Having that strong, deep cut between the muscles helps define and separate the chest. Each chest muscle is one wide, flat muscle that goes from the middle of the rib cage up to the shoulder joint, with a smaller muscle tucked underneath. The area referred to as inner chest is the line where the main chest muscle attaches to the rib cage. That deep cut down the middle of the chest appears because of the size of the muscles on either side. The bigger the pec muscle, the deeper the cut in between. So, the first step towards creating that separation is to develop a full, rounded chest. With a complete chest program covering a range of exercises. But within that plan, it's important to make sure those middle chest fibers are worked fully. Many common chest exercises underuse this part of the muscle, while others create maximum squeeze in that key area. So, this video will show you how to create maximum effort specifically in those middle chest fibers. With exercises and tips you can include in your whole chest day workout to help you build a full, impressive chest. Squeezing at the top of your rep encourages growth by forcing blood into the whole of the muscle. But on chest, some exercises prevent this happening because they limit the range of movement. A barbell press will help you to add size because it's good for handling heavy weight, but the hand position stops you reaching that full squeeze, missing out on working that key middle chest area. Pressing with dumbbells creates a greater range of movement for a full squeeze down that middle chest line. And to really hit that middle chest, hold the dumbbells together as you come up. Keeping that middle chest in tension for a greater part of the movement. Or use two plates pushed together, maintaining that squeeze. Use these kinds of movements in your chest workout the same way you'd use an isolation exercise for other body parts. So after your heavy compound movement, move on to a contraction exercise like these. Cables are also effective, keeping the handles together for constant tension on the middle chest. This is still a press, not a fly. So elbows go down by the body, not out to the sides. For maximum contraction on those fibers down the middle of the chest, maintaining the squeeze across the whole movement. So, you've mastered that full squeeze on the chest. Our next tip takes you one step further. The full range of movement for the chest muscle is from here to here. The fully shortened position is actually with the arm across the chest. So our next tip is to cross over, here at the bottom of the movement. Cables provide pretty much constant tension, but they also let you cross the handles at the front. And you can vary it up on this exercise by changing the angle. Standing or flat, crossing the arms out in front or below the waist. Always hitting that squeeze at the point of maximum tension. Our next tip will also increase the squeeze down the middle of the chest. By moving to single arm movements, like this single arm cable press. Isolating one side at a time for a better mind-muscle connection, focusing right in on that squeeze down the middle chest line. move the pulley to a low position for a cable raise. Again, with single arm allowing a full range of movement and a full squeeze at the top. Remember that as with any other body part, the definition on show depends on the level of body fat covering the muscle. So, a good diet and nutrition are also key to achieving your goals.